What up, everybody? This is RoxRite representing the Renegade Squadron and the Red Bull BC1 All-Stars. I'm here to tell you about the RoxRite 100 story. I'm going to just give you some history and a bit of a backstory to how I got started, where it came from, what inspired the idea of doing 100 wins. So basically, I started competing in 1998. I won my first contest in the summer of 98. From there on, I won a few more contests. So up to around, you know, 2001, 2002, I actually started linking up with Zulu Grenman, who became my mentor. And he's the one that actually advised me on keeping track of my victories. He just had mentioned that it would create more worth, more value for myself. So up to that point, I had only won maybe around 15 tournaments. It wasn't so far away from when I started, so I was able to backtrack and go back over my wins. And since then, I started keeping track of my wins. And also, the events weren't so often and not so many. From there on, I started competing more, started getting more in the scene, started being more active, started building a name, you know, started winning bigger tournaments, started going abroad, establishing myself as a competitive b-boy. One thing I want to get out of the way first, the point when I started competing and winning battles, I actually just tried to be as dope as I could. It wasn't just about the win, it was about winning with my style, it was about winning with pride, about what I represented and the history and lineage that I represented, right? That was what it was about for me. You know, if I could win with that, to me, that was really valuable and important. So carrying that mentality, that's to me what helped me stay consistent and stay active and motivated to compete. From around 2002 to 2009, I won quite a bit. I was winning more often. In 2009, I had gotten up to around 63 tournaments, I believe, or 62 tournaments. And that's the year actually that I released the video that was promoting the idea of winning 100 tournaments. I don't know, I was just sitting down, I thought about it, and I was like, shit, why not try to go for 100? Nobody's done that. Nobody's gotten 100 wins that you know of in breaking. I mean, that's something that I was pursuing, and since, you know, the scene kept growing in the competition side, I was like, you might as well create some kind of standard. But for me, the idea came from football. Growing up, I was a big football fan. I collected football cards. On the back of the cards, there's the statistics of each player, how many receptions they had, how many yards they got that year, how many touchdowns they scored that year. So looking into that, there was one wide receiver that played for the Seahawks. His name's Steve Largent. He was the first wide receiver to score 100 touchdowns in his career. And to me, I don't know, it always just stood out as a kid looking at that trading card and knowing that he had scored 100 and nobody had done it yet or broken that barrier again since him was something that was, you know, something unique, something that was one of a kind. And that's where that idea and the number 100 comes from, is from that. You know, it took longer than I would wanted to. I had in mind to try and knock it out, you know, in a 3-4 years. Around a 3-year span after I announced the video, when I was my most active point in my breaking career, I didn't compete more than 13 times a year. So I would win maybe 8-9 tournaments a year. So my goal was always to try and win more than I lost, right? Or just try to be more consistent in terms of, if I'm gonna put myself out there, I better be ready, right? So with everything that comes in life and all the obstacles you face from, you know, work, relationships, I mean, all these different things that come into play, you can't always be 110% mentally going into it. So it was like every battle that I did choose, I tried to be as ready as possible. And that way I gave myself a chance to try and come out on top. In the early years, this definitely, it was just like a free for all. But the goal was always to leave a name or leave a mark. And I mean, to leave a mark and build your name, whether you win or lost, you know. And to me, that was just as valuable as well. Just keeping track of wins, it is an important thing because I think it creates more worth for yourself as an artist, as a competitive b-boy, if that's what you're into. I mean, look at boxers, you know, when you compare it to something like boxing or the UFC, you got guys that their records are appealing. You know, you can have a boxer be undefeated, and if he's gonna fight another undefeated boxer, people want to see that. You know, that creates more worth. There's a statistic behind it. People are seeing that these guys have built up their careers and haven't lost a fight. And that even if you don't watch, even if you're not into it, like just the statistics behind it, that's intriguing. Like, oh, who's going to lose, right? You're going to go into it and see somebody's going to walk away a winner. And somebody's going to have to lose it for the first time. So it's the same thing in breaking, right? If you could win a lot of battles and have a good track record of wins, that creates worth. You know, I mean, look at UFC, you know, almost everybody has lost a fight. But when they have their, you know, maybe they'll lose two fights, right? And maybe they'll win like 15 in a row or 12 in a row. And then next thing you know, they're the reigning champion, or, you know, they've had many title defenses. I think that creates hype in itself as well. Besides the sport being something fun to watch, there's also numbers behind it that creates a different type of an audience. So with breaking, I think that that's something that is missing. I think that's something that the scene can benefit from and something that it can build on. So for me, that's what RoxRite 100 was about. And it was to inspire the next generations to try and create more worth around what they're doing, especially with the direction we're going. There's a lot of events. There's an event every weekend. There's multiple events every weekend. So you have to somehow create some kind of worth within that besides just winning another contest, right? So that's the reason why I did it. I think many people will surpass that, and you know, I want to see that, because I really see that there's a lot of talent coming up, and it's just amazing to see. That is the story of RoxRite 100, and you know, thank you Red Bull for actually pushing me to fulfill this dream of mine and this goal of mine, along with everybody else that has been by my side, has battled next to me, you know, from the Bonnie and Clydes to the 2-on-2s, the 3-on-3s, the crew battles, you know, all these opportunities that I got, you know, it wasn't just me alone in the end. It was also the journey of people around me, you know, and having those people believe in me the same way I believe in them. I'm here to tell you about the RoxRite 100 giveaway contest, where I will be giving away an Adidas RoxRite limited edition jersey, a poster designed by Broken Fingers about the 100 wins, a notepad, pins, and trading cards. So this is what you have to do. You have to hashtag RoxRite100, create a 10-second video of your best freeze frame, freeze stack combination, and tag me on it, put RoxRite100 on it, hashtag it. I will review all the videos, and I will pick one winner for all 5 items, and we will all be mailed to you. So thanks for tuning in. This concludes the vlog. I'll catch y'all next time. So hashtag RoxRite100 if you want to get those prizes, all right? Peace.